Hello students, today I'm here to explain you all the very first poem of your English language, that is Dust of Snow. So this poem has been written up by Robert Frost, and this poem consists of only 8 lines, that is it consists of 2 stanzas, 4 in each. So though it is a very short poem, but it gives you out a picture of an emotion of the poet here. So this poem consists of, as I already told you, the depth of emotion where the poet is describing, and he is just getting the help of the nature to express all his emotions. And I'll just read out the poem first, and then later will be going on to explain the poem. So the poem goes like this: the way of a crow shook down on me the dust of snow from a hemlock tree, has given my heart a change of mood and saved some part of a day I rued. So here I rued, it's nothing but to get regretted, feeling sorry for something which has happened. And the hemlock tree is a very poisonous tree, where it will be giving out the picture of similarly the Christmas tree itself, but it is not a Christmas tree, but it is a poisonous tree which was used for poisoning during the time of Socrates. So let me go with the depth of the poem now. So this poem has been published during the 1920s. It describes a winter's day, and the incident which is described in the poem is said to have probably taken place in the back of the poet's house itself. The poem has 2 stanzas, and it has 4 lines in it, and it is a very short poem. But it is one of the most widely read and acclaimed poems composed by Robert Frost. The speaker begins to tell about the winter's day, where the snow flakes have covered all the treetops. The tree, that is the speaker, is walking under one of these snow-covered trees. The tree is considered and identified as a North American conifer that will be known as the hemlock also. Since hemlock is a poison tree which cannot be associated with anything positive, in the sense it gives you out the thought and the picture of negativity, suddenly a crow which alights on that tree itself and which comes over flying and sit onto the tree. As a result of the motion caused by the crow's arrival, some of the flow of snow which was on the treetop, that is the snowflakes on the tree, fall on the speakers like rain. So the snow which has fell on to the speaker like a rain. Since the snowflakes are very light enough and tiny, the poet thinks that they look like white and immaculate dust particles. So it is resembling some of the dust particles over there. And the second stanza, it says that the speaker describes how the falled snowflakes have affected him. His mood is changed for before the fall of the snowflakes. The speaker was in a despairing mood, but after the fall of the snowflakes, he is glad. Why he is glad? So let's see. But what kind of a mood he was before? So that has to be observed here. The snowflakes have nothing affected, and it is creating another effect on the speaker, that he continues that he had not been looking forward to the particular day, and in fact the day was not going too well either. But now everything is changed. The speaker had imagined that the day would be a waste, but the shower of the snowflakes on his shoulder has changed his mood and mind. But what kind of a mood he was in? So that has to be observed. he realized that the day was not complete and it's not completely waste off. Some part of the day has been delightful because he has got a new experience. This new experience, which is providing the poet with the material needed for another wonderful poetic composition over there. So that also to be analyzed here. And he also says that what kind of a mood he was in. He was in a very sad mood and he was during off, in the sense he had some regression. It might be the losing of some person or the sadness over his illness, anything you can consider. And the analysis of the poem, it goes like this. The poet who is just using up the figure of speech in the poem, that a metaphor and a synecdoche. The poet, he uses the device of metaphor by comparing the white snowflakes at the top of the hemlock tree with the dust particles. The device of the synecdoche has been used very skillfully in the poem, in the presentation. The poet says that his heart has undergone a change of a mood because the shower of the snowflakes which made him the change of his mood. And the entire person is experiencing a better mood and delightful by seeing the atmosphere and the dust of the snow over there. He has forgotten of a while that he was very sad before the fall of the snowflakes. Thus, using hearts, the poem has represented total different thing in case of his entire life. Hemlock tree and the crows are the symbolically, it says about some evilness and ugliness. Hemlock is a poison that has been given to Socrates during the times of Socrates, I have already told you. And the crow is one of the ugliest of the bird. But however, in this poem, both these symbols unite and cause an event that is creating a very highly positive note and delightful note. The tree is covered with the snow. The crow alights on the tree and it moves, causes the snowflakes to fall on the poet. And speaker is experiencing a change of a mood that feels very delighted. And the poet used these two symbols in a very profound and a meaningful way, so that it conveys a message that sometimes even the negative things can create a kind of positive effect. So this has been written in a very light and a very cheerful tone, where the poem conveys a very clear message that the nature has its own mysteries and living with nature is one of the most beautiful experiences that a human can have. So by this, what we have to learn is the nature makes us so delightful and forget our worries and the sadness and the rudeness, whatever we will be having in our minds and even the hearts. And it gives you out a clear picture of the pleasantness and a kind of a playful mood with the help of the snowy region. And it also says about whatever the thoughts he has in mind. So that has been represented symbolically, hemlock tree and the crow, which resembles to a negative and the bad thing. So that has to be considered here. So it is a very short poem and it gives you out a depth of the emotion that the speaker had. So the poet himself is the speaker of the poem. So, and he expresses his emotions and whatever he has felt before and after the snowflakes. So this is up to the poem, The Dust of Snow. Hope you all understood, and I'll be meeting you up in all the next video. So till by then, do revise the poem, and happy learning.